Imagine I'm walking through the airport and someone gets a hold of my device. In my case, a Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 5. Hey, my phone! While losing the physical device would be costly, losing my personal data would be even more detrimental. And that would only be exponentially worse if it was an enterprise device with a ton of company data. Thankfully, security got my phone back, which is funny because I'm going to talk about security for mobile devices today. The most robust security strategy in use right now is zero trust, an approach that assumes that every connection and endpoint is a threat. Zero trust ensures that access to enterprise resources is only granted after a snapshot of the entire request context is analyzed, looking at the user, the device, and other details every time access is requested. Companies have been quick to apply this strategy to their cloud and their networks, but there's been a delay in extending it to their mobile devices. Given the vast amount of enterprise data that lives on these devices, it's critical that businesses understand how to effectively manage them. Today, I'm going to talk about the risks that come with mobile devices if they are not adequately accounted for in a company's security strategy. Let's dive into four right now. One, credential exposure. Static passwords, passcodes, and weak multi-factor authentication can leave companies exposed, as the correct credentials does not always equal correct user. For example, devices can be stolen or lost, and passwords and passcodes can be easily compromised. Two, device exposure. Devices, by their nature, are just a more exposed endpoint. For example, because they rely on cellular signals instead of Wi-Fi, it's hard to ensure that the network they're using are secure. Three, application exposure. Public-facing applications are a common initial access vector for hackers. Common reliance on third-party applications and libraries can leave enterprise applications exposed, even if they're secured because of unauthorized updates. Fourth and final, insider threat. Insider threat can show up in a variety of different ways, from a disgruntled employee turning rogue to a perfectly happy employee accidentally falling for a phishing scheme, a social engineering attack that targets the user through call and text. Unfortunately, this is super common, as a study found that 50% of companies had at least one insider attack in 2022. So now that we know these risks exist, what can you do to secure your mobile environment? Let's walk through an example of what should ideally happen in a zero-trust framework when an employee requests access to an enterprise resource. Sue is traveling for work and wants to knock out a few tasks before she boards her flight. She grabs her Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 5 to look at the latest updates on an NDA project she's been assigned to. To get access to the latest documents, she submits her credentials into her company's file sharing tool. Once the correct credentials have been submitted, they go to the policy, decision, and enforcement engine. This engine completes two different processes, a user context evaluation and a device context evaluation. These evaluations take information from the phone's identity and access management software, which is pulling data from the unified endpoint management software and mobile device management software on the device. The UEM and MDM are perpetually tracking and monitoring data points on the device, looking at things like Wi-Fi, device health, location, and even typing patterns to ensure that the phone is following the policies set by the company and that the device is in the hands of the authorized user. So, the IAM should easily be able to get the information that the policy decision and enforcement engine needs in order to complete its task. This should be a very seamless process, and the end user should get a decision almost immediately. So back to our example with Sue. If no red flags are raised, she will be granted access to those files. However, if a risk was raised, for example, two requests coming from her account within a span of 5 minutes in two different locations, there would be an additional authentication check, like typing in a passcode that was sent to her device. Providing she's able to do that, she'll be able to get access to those files. It's good practice to give employees only access to the files they need and to require re-authentication frequently. So in this example, Sue would only be given access to the file for her NDA project, not all the files that exist within the file sharing tool. Additionally, she should have to re-authenticate her credentials once she arrived in her second city. Now that we know what an ideal situation looks like, how do you go about implementing a system like this at your business? Let's walk through that right now. One. Start by focusing on your journey to the cloud. By modernizing your IAM infrastructure to a cloud-based or hybrid cloud-based solution, you can increase operational efficiency and technical agility. The cloud also allows for containerization that can separate out business systems and information that are unrelated. In this way, if a container is hacked, the perpetrator only has access to the files in that particular container, not all the data on the device. 2, deliver risk-based access. While every request needs to be vetted, the validation should be commensurate of the risk. This is important to ensure that the user experience is not negatively impacted. 3, simplify the deployment of your security solutions. Create a unified platform that has workforce and consumer access, identity governance, privacy and consent management that allows information to be seamlessly and easily shared without compromising security. And finally, consider the security features on the actual device. Security suites vary by manufacturer, so take the time to compare and review the actual offerings. For example, Samsung Knox supports a mobile zero trust vision by providing defense in depth, all the way down to the hardware level, and easily incorporates into a company's broader security strategy. Remember, your security is only as strong as your weakest endpoint, which is why you need to take the time to secure your mobile devices. Thanks for watching. Before you leave, please remember to click, like, and subscribe.